Just as there are myths of phenomenally large terrestrial creatures such as Yeti, abominable snowman, and many others, there are also reports of monstrously large and bizarre animals living at the incredible depths of our oceans. While the Kraken and Leviathan may be nothing more than myths, some animals grow to such incredible sizes, you will find some hard to believe. They are all products of deep sea gigantism. And given the depths at which they live, it is no wonder no footage or documentary has been able to sufficiently explain what causes these creepy marine organisms to become so big. You may already be developing the idea of animals such as the Greenland shark as one of such deep sea gigantic animals. But there are many more examples that would make the Greenland shark seem unpopular. In this video, therefore, we will be diving on an exploratory journey to observe examples of marine organisms with deep sea gigantism and also attempt explaining in the most understandable language what causes this little understood anomaly. Deep sea gigantism is the scientific term often used to describe any situation in which deep sea living organisms grow to be phenomenally larger than their shallow water counterpart. Apart from the all-too-obvious difference in size, animals with deep-sea gigantism also tend to live much longer. Interestingly, about 71% of the Earth's surface is submerged underwater, and the ocean holds over 96% of all the Earth's water. Given the expansive nature of the ocean, therefore, it is no wonder we know more about the Moon and Mars than we know about what's in the depths of our oceans. While several animals are known to exhibit deep-sea gigantism, we must caution that we are yet to discover them all. This is partly because exploration of these oceanic depths, such as the Mariana Trench, is nearly impossible. This is due to bone-crushing intense water pressure at these depths. Occasionally, when we make it to these depths, these creatures are often very elusive. Living at depths where there is immense pressure, absence of sunlight, and complete darkness, these animals have adapted to their environment such that some have developed keener senses and others, bioluminescence. We shall therefore examine examples of creatures of deep-sea gigantism. First on our list is the giant deep-sea-dwelling colossal squid, which lives as far down as 3,280 feet, or 1,000 meters in the Antarctic and South New Zealand waters. While the average size of a shallow water squid is just 2 feet, 60 centimeters, the colossal squid can grow to be 43 feet, or 13 meters long, and can weigh as much as 700 kilograms, thanks to deep-sea gigantism. A close cousin of the colossal squid is the giant squid. Giant squids measure also about 43 feet, or 13 meters. National Geographic has it that the largest ever found measured a whopping 59 feet, or 18 meters in length. It probably weighs over 1 ton. The third on the list is the Japanese spider crab. You probably may not have heard that before. While shallow water sea crabs, such as the long-beaked spider crab, often measure just about 0.4 inches across in diameter, the deep-sea Japanese spider crab is a phenomenally larger giant. It is often at depths of 160 to 2,000 feet, or 50 to 600 meters. It has 10 spider-like legs which measure 18 feet, 5.5 meters, from claw to claw, but the crab itself measures 13 feet, or 4 meters across, and lives to be 100 years old on average. It can be found in the Pacific water of Japan, and as far south as Taiwan. Fourth on the list of deep-sea gigantic animals is the giant tube worm, which was discovered relatively recently. First discovered in 1977, about 300 new species have been discovered since then. It lives close to the ocean's hydrothermal vents, where mineral-rich, extremely hot water seeps out of cracks in the ocean floor at depths up to 5,280 feet, or 1,600 meters. It measures 1.6 inches, or 4 centimeters across in diameter, and as much as 8 feet, or 2.4 meters in length. It feeds through chemosynthesis, as it has no eyes and no stomach. The 23 feet or 7 meters long Greenland shark also deserves to be included in our brief list. It weighs as much as 2,220 pounds, or 1,025 kilograms. According to Natural World Facts, there are 400-year-old specimens. They reside at depths reaching 6,500 feet, about 2,000 meters, where they live almost completely blind. Other deep-sea gigantic animals include the giant Pacific octopus and deep-sea isopod. Now to the interesting question. Why and how did they get this big? Given the inhospitable nature of oceanic depths, there is yet to be a comprehensive exploration of these depths and the unusual creatures which live therein. As a result, not much is known for certain about why and how these deep-sea giants get to be so big. However, there are three top theories developed from the research of three marine biologists which attempt at giving scientifically reasonable reasons as to the how and why of deep-sea gigantism. All three theories agree on why these animals get so big relative to their shallow water-dwelling counterparts. There are three major reasons why deep-sea creatures become so huge. These are the limited resources or food available at such depths, the fierce competition for such food, and the absence of predators. Food is limited because these organisms depend on food that drifts downward from shallower waters. These organisms therefore had to evolve larger bodies in order to increase energy conservation efficiency. This is because the bigger an animal is, the better it is at conserving energy. Also, since food is scarce, there is often competition over the available food. Hence, the bigger the animal is, the better chances of winning competition over food. Thirdly, there are few or no predators to keep the growth and population of these deep-sea giants in check. Having considered the why, let us discuss the how. Max Kleiber, Karl Bergman, and Craig McLean are three biologists who have conducted extensive research on deep-sea gigantism. Kleiber proposed that animals that are larger will tend to be more efficient. In other words, gigantic sea animals can conserve much-needed precious energy because they have a much smaller surface area through which body heat or energy is lost and much larger volume. Karl Bergman was a biologist who in 1847 published the result of his research on deep-sea gigantism. He came up with the rule which states, "Sea animals tend to increase in size with a decrease in temperature. This is why larger species live farther north and smaller ones farther south." Based on Bergman's observation, animals such as our deep-sea giants, which reside at ocean depths which are often very cold due to the absence of sunlight, often get to become bigger than their shallow water counterpart, simply because reduced water temperature means increased cell size and longer lifespan, since these animals would have a reduced low metabolic rate. There is also a larger amount of oxygen in cold, icy water. The third rule is the deep-sea isolation rule of McLean, who says that deep-sea animals are isolated from their shallow water counterparts and hence have evolved greater biodiversity, including an increase in size. To prove this, he used the Galapagos tortoise, which lives longer and dwarfs other tortoise species in size. As far as he is concerned, the deep sea is functionally similar to an island. Many amazing wonders exist in our little explored oceans, from the myriad of underwater lakes and rivers to volcanoes, seamounts, and underwater caves. Bizarre-looking gigantic-sized creatures are but one of the many hidden ocean wonders we are yet to fully unravel. Hopefully, with the increasing interest in and technological advancement which affords us greater opportunities of exploring our oceans, we will discover yet some yet-to-be-known deep-sea gigantic creatures. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.